Hi, this is Robert Palenik, the owner of Brutal Iron Gym. I want to make a quick little video kind of discussing some ways in which people can stay positive, stay on track, still kind of grow through the tough times they're facing currently. So a lot of my clients I work with in person and online are facing kind of stay-at-home kind of situations and restrictions. And I wanted to talk real quickly about some of the things we can do for kind of emotional and mental benefit, to help us not just kind of like shut down in the moment, but actually still find a way to flourish and grow and still move forward towards our goals. So I have a quick list here, and then I'm going to have some extra supporting information combined with this post as well. So the big thing is to be proactive. Recognize that there are things you can still control. There are things you can still do, so control the hell out of them, okay? You'll also find that by staying active and doing actions, that it lessens anxiety and depression because you feel kind of more progressive and it gives you kind of a busyness. So they say idle hands are the devil's playground, so idle minds are also not that great as well. So it's good to stay proactive and kind of stay the course as much as we can, focus on what we can control, rather than what we can't. So the first step I have here is information. So knowing what and how and where and what you can do about things. So if we're looking at training, for example, how do we stay active in our exercise? Is information helps. So what are some at-home workout options? So we have a podcast we did recently, number 559, titled At-Home Workouts. And I'll have that included in the post here, link for it. But in that one, we talk about a structure you can use for at-home workouts, regardless of what equipment you have available. So that would be a great resource. So there are tons of resources right now being pushed out on social media, which is freaking fantastic. It's awesome that everybody is joining in with exercise ideas and workout kind of ideas. So what we included in our podcast was a structure you can use with any exercise, any equipment, and you can use any day. So it's just kind of something you can use forever, even after this time passes, how you can do future at-home workouts or travel workouts, or even just a structure you can use in the gym, but it gives us that openness to variables of what equipment we have, what restraints we have, and whatnot. We also have other information available as well in terms of exercise selections and different formats for workouts and whatnot. So if you're struggling, as I go through these five things, if you're struggling with any one in particular or multiples of them, shoot us an email to brutalirongym@gmail.com and we'll help you get extra kind of support for these. But that's the first thing we want to look at is the first thing we want to tackle is knowing what can we do, what are the actions I can take, and how can I do that. So if you're, that's the first thing. Get some information, figure out a game plan, you know, put together what actions you can still do. Then we want to work on tracking and adherence. So we do have an adherence chart for activities, whether it's nutritional or like, you know, exercise stuff. So if you want a tracking chart or an adherence chart, email us again at brutalirongym@gmail.com. We'll send it to you for free. But that is a big thing, is if you track what you're doing, it allows you to see how well you're doing and you don't end up kind of falling into self-lies in which we actually aren't really doing the things we think we're doing. This helps you kind of see it in black and white. I know when I've gotten through different times in my life, getting through like injury rehab and whatnot, I used to put a calendar on the wall and check off every day if I did the activity or not. So I have a digital feature of that on my phone now where I have a goal tracker app on my phone. And every day I have 8 things that if I do them per day, it makes me feel like I'm living the best life possible. So I track those and make sure I get them every day. So it helps me to see on which of the 8 I'm maybe falling behind, what's my percentage of accuracy of adherence. So it really just helps you kind of have data that you can then kind of modify and adjust to and make sure that you're not falling behind in any area, or it raises your awareness to which areas you still need to improve upon. So that's a big thing. So once you have information, you know what you should do, track it and make sure you're actually doing it. And that's going to help motivate you. So you won't want to see days you missed. You won't want to see mistakes. So that can be motivating as well. Another way to motivate yourself is accountability. This can be done with an accountability partner. Just find someone else who has a similar goal. You know, kind of text each other, email each other, stay in touch with each other. And that can help see how they're doing. You can pick them up or they can pick you up whenever one or the other is struggling. You can also do social media type accountability. You can post what your plans are and then post every day, you know, if you did it or not. Not everybody's going to give a crap, but it helps for you to post it and not want to miss anything here or there for those that do follow you and do care. You can also find accountability by showing others what can be done. You can let your story be a positive aspect or a positive influence into others' lives. So that's another way of kind of holding yourself accountable to your best, is by showing others what their best may be. The fourth thing we have there is daily motivators. And this is extremely, extremely important. You're going to feel maybe motivated at first to get a game plan, to get started. You might do great on day one, day two, day three, you're kind of tired, you're fatigued, you have like a lot of worries and stress on the mind, and things might not seem as important, or you might seem overwhelmed, and it's harder sometimes to stay with things. Motivation is not a one and done type thing. You have to renew motivation, and very often, I would say almost 100% of the time, whatever your motivators are need renewed as well. So something might motivate you for a week, but then it kind of fades off, so you have to find a new one. So pick that as one of your daily activities, daily things that you want to do. A daily goal is finding some motivation, whether that's a video on YouTube, whether it's a song you really like. Like I said, maybe it's the accountability factor of posting something every day. Maybe it'll motivate others to be their best. So you want to find daily ways to motivate yourself, and then have big motivators. Have something that you want to accomplish at the end of, say, 2 weeks, and see if you can do it day by day by day. And that helps to motivate you as well. So daily motivators are absolutely important. And then big time motivators are absolutely important. So these are 5 steps that you can take in order to stay in control of your life and stay progressive and stay improving. So give these a try. If you want any help with any information in any of these 5, reach out to us. Our email is brutalirongym@gmail.com. We're happy to help. We'll send you everything for free. You can even email us if you want to every day if you worked out. So use any resource you have available to you to ensure that you live the best life possible. So we wanted to kind of present this and offer it up. So if you need anything, let us know. Best of luck with all the craziness going on. Please, 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 if you're struggling at all, reach out to somebody. There's a lot of people happy to help, more than you'd ever realize. Okay, so good luck to everybody. Let us know if you need anything. Thank you for watching.